thank you so much for tuning in. Today I'm going to be showing you a look which I fell in love with. It was Lady Gaga's look on the Grammy Awards when she was walking down a red carpet. She was one of the best people dressed there and her makeup was fantastic. It suited her beautifully. So now I'm going to be showing you how to get this look. This was an example. I wanted to put on a lighter wig so you guys can get a feeling of what it would look with a lighter wig. And I'm going to show you what it looks with my own hair. Okay, now that I took off the wig, this is how the look looks with my own hair. It still looks great, but there was a reason why Lady Gaga was wearing that wig, because with that lighter wig and that dress and the jewelry, it really all blended in perfectly and she looks perfect. So let's get down to the tutorial. Alright, first I'm going to be taking my Sigma concealer brush in F70 and I'm going to be applying a white base. Now we're going to be taking a white eyeshadow and I'm going to be using Makeup Geek's White Lies, and I'm also going to be using a large shader brush from Sigma in E60. And just applying this on the inner third of the eye, and we can apply it right away below the eyebrow here. Now I'm going to be using my Inglot eyeshadows. I'm going to be using this shade first, and then after that I'm going to be applying this shade on the outer rim. So let's start with this one. So we're going to be applying it on the center of the eyelid. This eyeshadow is very light, so you will need to layer it. Now we're going to be picking up this eyeshadow right there with the same brush, and we're going to be applying it on the outer third of the eyelid, like that. Now I'm just going to be applying a little bit more white, and I'm using a disposable sponge brush applicator because I feel that with these light colors it picks up the color and applies it much better than a brush. Now with a fluffy brush I'm going to be using Sigma's E45, just going to lightly blend these edges first of all. Okay, and then just a little bit here, like that. Now using Mango Tango from Makeup Geek, I'm just going to be applying it into the crease here. And then I'm going to take a clean tapered brush, E45, which has nothing on it, and just make sure that I blend everything out. Now going with that same color which we applied on the outer rim and taking a small pencil brush, apply that color on the lower eyelid. Now taking a black eyeshadow, I'm just going to be smudging it lightly on right below my lash line. This is also going to give definition. Using my Makeup Geek gel liner in Immortal and my Sigma brush in E10, it's a very small liner, I'm going to be applying that cat-like flick on my eye. One thing I wanted to mention is that you don't go beyond this point right there, because if you look at the picture, she doesn't have any liner on the inner part. It goes from here up. I don't like this glossy effect, so we're just going to apply a matte eyeshadow. We're using Corrupt from Makeup Geek. Alright, so now we're going to be picking up Sigma Beauty's Flat Definer Brush in E15. And we're just going to be drawing that flick here. So the key to this look are the lashes. I'm first going to be applying some normal wispies. And then I'm going to be applying another set of wispies just on the outer rim right here so we can get a better flick. I forgot to add one more magical touch. If you guys notice that, like, the inner rim right here where it's kind of white, she had glitter. So I'm going to be using my glitter from Inglot. It's the shade called 55. It's a, like, a white glitter. So you really just need a little bit. And what you can do with your hand, I actually have way too much as it is. With your hand, you just want to apply some of the glitter right there. And hopefully you guys now can see how it gets that full glitter effect that she had. It's much more glittery and stuff, and that is the key of the look. I'm going to be quickly bronzing my skin just a little bit. I already started a bit, so just gonna apply a little bit more. Okay, so for the lips, I'm going to be using Sigma's Lip Base and Go Dutch. And over that, I'm going to be applying Sigma's Lip Vex in All Hearts. It's this color. And there we go. This is what it looks like when I have my own hair up. It's quite different because Lady Gaga, she had almost like a silvery, like a really light blonde hair, which was on the border of like gray hair in my personal opinion. So that's what it looks like on my hair. I'm gonna be applying a white wig so you guys can get the actual feeling of this and see what it looks like. Alright guys, this is what it looks like with a lighter wig on, and I know it's not the Lady Gaga one, but you guys can get the feel of it. And for example, if I would apply anything like this color, the aqua green color she had, it actually makes the eyeshadow pop up. And this is why you may have noticed when she had a gray dress on, like a, actually I better said like something silvery, and she had green jewelry. So this not only helped her makeup pop up more, but it also made her green eyes pop up a lot. So you're going to see me showing you, actually you probably saw a picture in the intro where I colored my eyes a bit more green so you guys can get a feel of the entire look, what it would look like that. But this is, as you can see, was a really smart way that her makeup artist and her entire team did it. They made her wear a lighter wig. I'm certain that's not her hair because I saw the rims of the wig. It was a little bit, it was like a very light ashy blonde, and the dress and the jewelry and the colors, it all fit in perfectly. It was well synchronized. It, for me, it was one of the best looks at the Grammy Awards. It was really exciting seeing it. I really liked the play of color. It complimented her a lot. It made her look younger and very classic and glamorous. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'm going to see you Thursday with the Poltergeist 2015 inspired scary doll makeup. Yes, they finally did a redo of Poltergeist, and I saw the doll and I was like, oh my god, right? In the original there was a doll, and I saw this doll and the doll reminded me of Ronald McDonald's. You guys are going to see the tutorial very soon. If you're on my Facebook, you already have a sneak peek of what it looks like, and that's that. Thank you guys. Bye.